Hi everyone, Chris here. Welcome to World List. From lions running around Disney to wolves in the streets of LA, here are 10 animals that escaped from the zoo. Hey, it happens. Number 10, get back here, gorilla. When it comes to our primate friends, it's really incredible how similar we are to them in some ways. It's not just size or that they have the ability to do things like humans, they're also incredibly intelligent, such is the case with Evelyn and Jim from the Los Angeles Zoo, who are quite the escape artists and show it off quite frequently. How so? Well, here's the thing, the enclosure that they're in within the zoo wasn't exactly made for them. In fact, it was made for bears, which is an entirely different kind of animal in more ways than one. Anyway, because of the differences, Evelyn and Jim are able to climb up vines that are in the enclosure, as well as climb up on the walls, or in one case, actually jump over them in a single bound. Oh yeah, these are some very athletic gorillas. What's more, they've escaped so many times from the Los Angeles Zoo that they've received warnings from the government about it. And can you blame them? Gorillas can be huge, and having them walk through a zoo full of people, let alone Los Angeles, would be very frightening indeed. Well, they're back now, but it may only be a matter of time before they strike out again. King Kong vibes, anyone? Number 9. Fly, Flamingo. Flamingos are very interesting creatures when you think about it. From their pink feathers to standing on one leg and their crazy habitats, they're very unique creatures. So it's not a surprise that we love to see them in a zoo. They're a standout attraction. However, and I speak from experience on this, if you're in a zoo in Kansas, you're probably desperate to get the heck out. Now, I'm not trying to insult the state here, but let's face it, there's not a lot there, and a particular flamingo seems to agree with that. For in 2005, when it saw an opening to escape, it took it. But wait, that's not the end of the story. In fact, it's just the beginning. So the flamingo escaped, and as you might expect, a search party was held to go and find it. But they didn't. Hold on, we're still not done here. Fast forward 8 years, and a bird watcher of all things found our escapee flamingo in the Texas Gulf Coast. More happily though, he had found a mate. And if you're curious how the bird watcher knew it was the escaped flamingo, don't worry, I was curious too. The bird still had its band that helped identify it. Interestingly enough, the mate also had a band, and it was traced back to a nature reserve in Mexico. Upon being told about this, the Kansas Zoo said it would allow the flamingo to remain where it was. That's nice, right? All's well that ends well. Number 8. Escape and regret. Raccoons get a bad rap, I am saying that right now. Yeah, they rummage through the trash and they'll attack if provoked, but they're pretty clever creatures who should be respected. Case in point, let me tell you about a raccoon named Misty. Misty was in the Tropiquaria Zoo in Somerset, England. This zoo had never had a problem with their raccoon guests, and thus it seemed that they were happy with their new home. Yeah, they would soon know better. To their credit, the zoo people did make an enclosure that made it near impossible for Misty or her fellow raccoons to escape. But then Mother Nature decided to intervene. The weather poured down rain and even flooded areas near the zoo. So now Misty's cage didn't have hardened dirt. It was very soft, drenched dirt. See where I'm leading with this? Yep, she dug a hole and she got out of Dodge, Somerset. However, she was caught 5 weeks later. And surprisingly, she was in a building very close to her enclosure. So why was she still there? Well, some speculate that she regretted leaving her fellow raccoon behind but couldn't get back to him. Well, they're reunited now. Number 7, the Lion Queen. There are many animals that can escape from zoos and not be harmful to the human population. But what about lions, though? Yeah, they're not one of them. For even when declawed, they can still hurt people. So imagine the horror that Disney parkgoers felt back in the 90s when a lioness escaped her cage and started to walk among the grounds. Oh yeah, this happened. And it was in Kissimmee's Jungle Land Zoo. Her name was Nala, after the character from Lion King. How poetic. And she was a robust 450 pounds. She escaped while some zoo workers were cleaning her cage, which happens a lot with zoo animals, believe it or not. Anyway, now free, Nala walked around the grounds, and people most definitely took notice. She was on the lam for 5 days, just wandering around. Thankfully for all involved, she was found and brought back to her cage. And no, no one was hurt, but it could have gone another way. Number 6, penguins gotta do. You might think that certain creatures wouldn't be capable of breaking free from the containment of a zoo, but when there's a will, there's a way, such as the case for Penguin 337 at the Tokyo Sea Life Park back in 2012. And on a side note, why in the world would you name a penguin that? That's just mean. I mean, pointing and saying, "Hey, you penguin," that might actually be nicer at this point. The Tokyo Sea Life Park had created pools for its penguins so they could live happily, but Penguin 337, still hate the name, he just wasn't having it. So the moment it got the chance, it bolted and actually found a way into Tokyo. This is a smart penguin. I wonder if he knows Skipper from Penguins of Madagascar. The zoo spent 2 months trying to find the penguin, not for pride, but for the penguin's safety. 337 had been raised within the zoo, and creatures of this nature have trouble living in the wild. But when they found him, he was fine. He was healthy and well-fed, so they left him there. I doubt, though, that they'll be as kind with other penguins, sadly. Number 5. Come for love, leave for freedom. Here's a fun tale for you. In India, a wild tiger had come onto the grounds of the Adakon Zoo. Why? Well, apparently it could sense the presence of a tigress and wanted to mate with her. Though scared at first, and who wouldn't be, they allowed the tiger into the pen. Weirdly, everything was fine for a few weeks. The wild tiger seemed right at home in the exhibit. But there's a reason there's a phrase called caged tiger. It doesn't end well most times. So when the tiger got bored of the place, it ripped through some wiring and made its way up above a 20-foot security wall and promptly proceeded to go back to the wild. Now, before you say that's too good to be true, there was a camera that caught the whole escape. So yeah, it happened and it was caught on camera. Number 4. Gored through the heart and you're to blame. What's more weird than a tiger entering a zoo for love? How about a rhino busting out of one because of heartbreak? That's exactly what happened in the Montero Zoo near Adelaide in South Australia. His name was Satara, and he had a mate within the zoo there. One day, though, he literally charged out of his pen and headed to another part of the zoo where there were other rhinos. He was eventually brought back into his pen. So what happened? Well, his mate had apparently found a younger rhino to go be with, and when Santara found out, he went nuts. Just goes to show, even animals can suffer from extreme heartbreak. Number 3. I'm on the hunt, I'm after you. If you didn't know, I love wolves. There's just something about them that's so impressive. But I've also got to admit that I'd rather see a wolf from a very, very safe distance, maybe a zoo, rather than run into one in the wild. Or more importantly, especially not on the streets of Los Angeles. And no, I'm not talking about The Wolf on Wall Street, because that movie took place mostly in New York. And also, I'm talking about a real wolf here. But in the Los Angeles Zoo, they had an issue with a wolf in the 70s that has a very interesting ending. You see, a wolf kept escaping the zoo somehow. And though it would be brought back, it would eventually escape again. Virginia the wolf was very clever and very persistent. And then after one escape, she was never found. I want you to picture that, okay? A wolf loose in Los Angeles. How many people do you think were out looking for it? Probably a lot, but Virginia was never found. Did she make it to the woods or a safe area? Was she killed and never found? No one knows, and it's a mystery to this day. Number 2. Monkeying around town. In 1935, Long Island found itself in the presence of a serious epidemic, but not a disease, but rather they were plagued by monkeys. No, I'm serious. And they're called Rhesus monkeys, and they were kept at an exotic animal park, one that was run by legendary animal collector Frank Buck. So what happened? Well, someone left their pen open, and 170 Rhesus monkeys left and headed towards a nearby town. Can you imagine living in a quiet town and then starting to think you're hearing monkeys? Then you look outside, and there are monkeys! They're all over the place! That must have been a sight, and not exactly a good one either. It was so bad that the park was offering rewards to anyone who was able to capture one of these monkeys and return it to them. Talk about incentive! Number 1. The escape artist. Now, I've shown you a lot of animals who have escaped their pens, and many of them have escaped multiple times. But when it comes to Ken Allen, he's in a league all his own. So who's Ken Allen then? Well, he was an orangutan that lived in the San Diego Zoo back in 1985. And he had a penchant for not just getting out of his cage, but he knew how to make sure he didn't reveal how he did it. And so during the summer of 85, Ken repeatedly got out of his cage, and he made the most of his time. He even went and found another orangutan and taunted him, because that one wasn't very nice. Ken even picked up a crowbar after one escape, but thankfully he didn't use it. Eventually, the zoo got fed up and did everything they could to find out how Ken was getting out. They didn't know at the time, but he used handholds that weren't very visible or even reachable at times to get out. So the zoo decided to spy on Ken to figure out his tricks. But he knew he was being watched and refused to show. Given that, they hired experienced rock climbers to figure it out. And when they did, they had to spend $40,000 to fix the cage so he couldn't escape again. Fun fact, during his reign, Ken was so popular that he had his own fan club. Thanks for watching. What did you think of these animal escape stories? Which one did you like the most? Let us know in the comments. Be sure to subscribe to World List, and I'll see you next time.